हेलो फ्रेंड, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल टेक W3 वे। दिस इज विजय कुमार। इन द लास्ट लेसन वी हैव टू लर्न हाउ टू कॉल ए जावास्क्रिप्ट फंक्शन इन लाइटनिंग कंपोनेंट। इन दिस लेसन वी विल बी सी हाउ टू कम्युनिकेट फ्रॉम चाइल्ड टू पेरेंट कंपोनेंट इन ऑरा कंपोनेंट। सो हियर आई विल बी यूजिंग बाउंड एंड अनबाउंड एक्सप्रेशन टू कम्युनिकेट ईच अदर ऑफ लाइटनिंग कंपोनेंट। So we will be pass the attribute value from child to parent component in our lightning component. So let's jump to my Salesforce. So first I will create child component, then we'll create parent component, and child component will be called into the parent component. So and parent component will be called into the lightning app, so that I will can see the render value. So this is my existing my custom app application. Now I am creating a child component. So simply file new and lightning component, and here the name of the component child CMP, submit, and there is a controller for the child, and I am creating another one component parent CMP component. So here is the parent component controller. In the child component I am creating our attribute name, child status, type boolean, and default value false. Then I create a div. Before create a div I will this. Yes. So here class SSDS P around medium in this inside the div I will create a form div class SLDS grid SLDS wrap. It is a predefined CSS class of the library and system. So in this grid I will create a div SLDS call SLDS size 6 of 12. Then inside the div I will create a lightning input field, lightning input type equal to text level equal to name, and here I will add a class name SLDS P horizontal small. So I create a lightning input field for the name, same copy the div and paste below. Here we will pass the phone and data type equal to phone. Copy the div and paste for the email level, email data type, email. Copy the div, paste for the city. City and type data will be text. So in the child component, I am creating a form, and this will be by default hide. So by default this form will be not display on the browser. So I will use Aura if here. Aura if this Aura if right to the whole of the content, and here will be passed this attribute. This attribute by default is a false, so that by default it is not display on the browser. Aura if is true. इक्वल टू चाइल्ड कंपोनेंट डॉट चाइल्ड कंपोनेंट। सो इन द पैरेंट कंपोनेंट आई विल क्रिएट ए लाइटनिंग बटन। सो दिस कंपोनेंट ड्राइव टू द इनसाइड द डिव डिव क्लास इक्वल टू एस एल डी एस ई अराउंड मीडियम एंड देर इज ए लाइटनिंग कार्ड। सो लाइटनिंग कार्ड ड्राइव ऑल ओवर द कंटेंट लाइटनिंग कार्ड। सो लाइटनिंग कार्ड बेसिकली गिव ए बैकग्राउंड कलर ऑफ वाइट कलर। सो इफ डोंट यूज द लाइटनिंग कार्ड द बैकग्राउंड कलर नॉट अप्लाई इन द कंपोनेंट। सो इट विल गिव ए वाइट बैकग्राउंड टू द कंटेंट एंड इनसाइड द लाइटनिंग कार्ड आई विल क्रिएट ए लाइटनिंग बटन। क्लोज द टैग वेरिएंट ब्रांड so that it's the button color will be displayed as a blue color and label click me and I will pass a function so on click here path of c dot name the function handler handler action so the sentence is calling the function of JavaScript exclamation c dot function name. So I will create a function handler action and then I will in the parent component there is a parent status which is a boolean type fields. So I will pass value true. So if passing the true this value will be passed into the child attribute and whenever this attribute called true then this font will be displayed. So now I am creating a function in the parent component function and in the function there are three parameters pass component controller and helper component event and helper and here I will set the component component dot set equal to this is the attribute name so here we'll call double quote v dot name of the attribute and passing the value true. So whenever click on the button this function will be called and I am setting the parameter true to this variable. So whenever this variable got true then this will be passed into this value will be passed to the this attribute variable. This attribute variable is a part of the child component. So whenever this component got a true value then this condition will be fulfilled and the form will be displayed. Now this child parent component calling into the custom app. So now going to preview this browser. So here button is display, there is a no space between left, so I am giving a space left. So wrap a div this button wrap to the div and here I will give a space. So I take class name SLDS P around medium. So whenever click on the button, this child component will be visible. So in the child component, I have created a small form. There is a form field, name, phone, email, and city. So this component, child component, calling into the parent component. By default, this child component attribute value is by default false, so it is not displayed. Whenever it got a true, then it will be automatically displayed. So true value I will send from the on click button from child component. This attribute value will be passed to the child attributes value. So now I am clicking on the button. So once I click the button, the value attribute value passed to the true message, and thus the child component form that is created visual. So friends, in this example, I am sending a attribute value from child component to parent component using the unbound and expression. So try to do from your side in your personal org. If you getting anything issue to passing the attribute value from child to parent, please write in comment box, and don't forget to check and subscribe my channel Tech W3BL. Thank you.